this election seems to be, at least right now, about embracing outsiders, Republicans liking Donald Trump and Dr. Ben Carson and Carly Fiorina, people who have never before held elective office. We just saw Governor Rick Perry, the longest serving governor in Texas history, drop out. You have spent a lifetime working in politics and government. Why should voters, and how are you going to convince them that you're the right choice when they're desperate for somebody who is not part of politics and government?
Because they actually want someone who can get the job done. All these other folks can talk all they want. Remember, Barack Obama had never run anything in government before. And we see what a lousy president he's been, not just ideologically, but in terms of actually running things. I've run things. I've actually got things done. If you want someone who will fight and win, not just win three elections in 4 years in a blue state like we did, but win and get results without compromising common sense, conservative principles, then I'm the candidate. I've shown I can take on those same powerful special interests. They spent in three elections almost $100 million trying to take me out. It was the big government union bosses and the liberal special interests in Washington.
I respect that you've taken on Democratic special interests in Wisconsin, but you've been backed by Republican special interests like the Koch brothers, right? How does that square with what you're saying about taking on special interests, or do you think only liberal special interests are the ones worth taking on?
I'm taking on the ones in Washington. In my state, I didn't just take on the unions and the Democrats early on. There was great support from the Assembly and some from the Senate, people like State Senator Scott Fitzgerald, but there were some senators, including some who'd been in the leadership, who didn't want to do the kind of reform. So I'm willing to take on anyone. I stood up to 100,000 protesters. I took on the death threats. I took on threats from my family. We pushed back when they took us to federal and state court. We pushed back when they went after our state senators. They went after me in a recall election and we won, and they made me the number one target in America. Number one in America last year.
But aren't the Koch brothers special interests too? Can you give me an example of one time that you took on a conservative special interest?
I tell you flat out, when I took on the $100 million or so, I raised $80 million in three elections in 4.5 years, and 70% of that came from people who gave me $75 or less. We raised it for more than 300,000 donors in all 50 states. That's grassroots. That's not allegiance to one group or another. That's actually listening to the people, the hardworking people all across this country who said they want a leader who's going to stand up and take on the special interests. The folks in Washington, including folks in my own party, I've spoken out about my frustration about Obamacare. I've spoken out on the fact that on things like Planned Parenthood, which I defunded more than 4 years ago in a blue state, long before these videotapes, we did it in a blue state. There's no reason why it can't be done in Washington. And I lay some of that blame on the leadership in the Congress. As president, I'm going to step up and lead for all of America, and we're going to get things done no matter who stands in the way.